It's crazy that you were like, oh man, love Donkey Kong Country. Donkey Kong Country 2, wow. Maybe my favorite game ever made. The third one, I'll skip it.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Jirard.
Yeah.
Does this mean?
Yeah.
That you're canceling the Completionist?
Yes, it means that. It means I'm fucking done with video games. Bye, everyone.
This is it. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, everyone.
The last video game you'll ever see me play.
We gotta turn down this.
No, let's leave it loud.
Fuck it. You're right.
Everyone, welcome. I'm Jirard.
This is the last video on our channel.
True. For clickbait purposes, Ted, call this one the last video ever and spell ever all fucked up.
Yeah.
If there's not a 4 in there, Ted, you're fired.
Got you guys. It's not our last episode.
Not our last episode, everyone. Calm down.
We're not.
It's one of my favorite games of all time. I love this game.
We just said, fuck it, let's do it.
Yeah, why not?
It's not why like not? The Completionist episode.
No,
it's
but
just...
we are going to do 100% playthrough.
Yeah, we're going to get everything.
Because I know everything.
Donkey Kong Country Tang.
All right, well, I get Alex. Let's make this old Completionist episode feel good.
This old Completionist episode?
I don't know what the fuck I meant to say. I think I meant to say Beard Bros episode.
What do you mean?
Will you please?
This old Completionist
I'm sorry,
episode.
I meant to say, you know what I mean. Just give everyone a little insight on some trivia of this game.
You want to know some trivia
facts?
I
want some trivia, because let me tell you something. I know nothing about this game other than it's my fucking favorite.
You don't know anything about it like, other than that's your favorite?
Like, in... and like, what I mean is, like, in regards to, like, actual trivia.
All right, check it out. Did you know that at one point in time they were going to make this game available on the Virtual Boy?
Yeah, and there actually is video footage of that.
There was...
Thank you, did you know...
Did you ner?
Actually, I don't know if there was video footage, but there wasn't.
It definitely happened, but really, I don't know how they could have done it because it was such a babby system compared to.
Babby system?
I mean, it just didn't have the tech. Like, I don't know how this game could ever be.
Right.
On there.
Yeah.
In Nintendo Power's 1997 100 Best Nintendo Games of All Time issue.
Yeah.
Donkey Kong Country 2 placed 33rd.
In their top 100 games?
In 97.
That's dumb.
I don't know, like,
way
I
higher,
bet you a lot of the
higher,
older
bros.
Games made it onto the
way
list.
Way high. Oh. No. That's,
I bet you a lot of the older games were still on the list in 97. They were only 10 years old at the time.
I mean, yeah. Oh, it was a Koopa. I'm gonna beat it.
So did
I'm
you ever?
Beat it. I'm gonna beat it.
This is weird. I never thought of this.
Yeah.
Kong Quest.
Yeah.
It's called
Diddy's Kong Quest. Is in Conquest.
Yeah, I never thought about Conquest.
I remember, like, someone pointed it out, and I was like, what?
But I think it's because, like, almost like Mandela effect style. I thought this game was called Diddy Kong's Quest. For the longest time. Because his name's Diddy Kong.
Yeah.
I thought it was Diddy Kong's Quest.
I get you, yeah.
But it's Diddy's Kong Quest.
Yeah.
Which is such a weird name for a game.
It is weird. That was level one, by the way. Alright, so...
For some reason, this game you start with four lives instead of five.
Off.
It's a little bright.
Did I fuck it up?
I don't think so. I think...
It looks better on my screen than it does...
It's not like... Wrong. It's just like really, really clear and bright, so it's lighter than normal.
Sure. So how you know you're done with this level, or at least completing it, is she says Pirate Panic. Exclamation point indicates that we got all of the bonus barrels, and the DK circle means we got the DK coin in the level.
So that's like everything.
Yeah.
I like the name of that level in Italian better. It's boarding.
Find the token.
So this level's called Main Brace Mayhem.
Mm-hmm.
In this version of the game.
Yeah.
In the Italian version, it's called Hordes of Ropes.
I would prefer them to say ropes. Uh-oh.
So we're going to talk about Gangplank Scallion a little bit for a second here.
All right.
In Donkey Kong Country, it is never explained how the ship sails away from DK Island just before the battle with King K. Rool. Doesn't make any fucking sense.
Wait, what?
What do you mean?
Wait, explain that again?
The Gangplank Galleon in Donkey Kong Country 1?
Mm-hmm.
It, like, sails away from the island.
Yeah.
And then you fight K. Rool.
Oh, I didn't even think about that.
Doesn't make sense.
Maybe you're on the boat?
I guess. I don't know. But if we're gonna talk about it in DK Country 2, the, Game Boy Advance remake of this game has the boat docked on the east side of the island and not on the west side for some reason. Really weird. I wonder why. Pretty bizarre. Also, the German translation of Lockjaw's Locker, right?
Trivia is incredible with these names.
So there's a level called Lockjaw's Locker.
Yeah.
It's like, I think, the fourth level.
Yeah.
We'll
see it eventually.
Yeah. The German translation of it is Sinking Dutchman.
Mm-hmm.
Which makes me think, and this is something that the person on the wiki speculated as well, that the whole ship in general is a reference to the Flying Dutchman.
The ghost.
Yeah, which I don't, I mean, actually, now that I'm thinking about it,
like, There's a few references like that in this game as well.
To ghost ships?
Yeah, or like, just pirate
big ghosts.
Ass pirate ghosts.
It's really weird that pirates are like a part of the Donkey Kong
lore.
Yeah, like,
it's only this one. It's only this one. Well, I guess...
No, there's, like, pirates. Like, in the first one, too, there's pirates. And in the third one.
Yo, she's killing it. After level 2, 14 lives come at me. Oh. That one's done. Moving on to Gangplank Galley.
Gangplank Galley, in Japanese, is called Athletic Deck.
Wow.
Yeah. There you go.
Finding that token. I think it's actually this third one.
It's also the first appearance of the invincibility barrels in this game.
Oh, really?
Yep.
That makes sense.
I mean, it's going to be one of the first levels.
So, check this out. I'm just going to go ahead and do this.
Secrets.
Yo, I'm pretty sure that the game's bugging out.
Why?
Because every now and then we come back from a bonus stage and, like, everything's way brighter than it should be.
I think you're just used to, like, not playing this on a... HDTV with, like, a digital file instead of the cartridge.
I don't know, man.
It looks pretty normal to me. It just, these games look a lot different on Super Nintendo because the graphics are really weird. How often do you play this game?
This game?
Yeah.
At least 4 times a year.
That's crazy. I don't think there's a single game I have that's like that, except maybe, like, Mario World. But that's only, like, when I'm, like, shitting or on a plane or something.
Like, Link to the Past and this, I probably play at least a minimum of either or once a year, at the very least.
There really aren't that many games that I replay. Like, Kelly right now, she's in the middle of her, like, third full Skyrim playthrough. She's, like, 85 hours in.
That's just not my jam. I can't do that.
Right, I'm just saying, like, that's a lot of time.
Yeah.
That's a lot of time. Question of the day. Is there a game that you replay over and over? That's surprising.
Oh. Missed my balloon.
A game that you replay over and over that's surprising.
This is Completionist theme. It's the bonus theme. That's where it comes from.
I play Kirby every once in a while.
Kirby's always good.
The first Kirby.
Hey, recover!
You can beat it in one sitting. Pretty cool.
Smoke weed every day.
Don't smoke weed, you guys.
Yeah, dude, that stuff's basically poison. Stay away from it.
All right, so that one's done. Lockjaw's Locker, here we go.
Yeah, this is the one that references the Dutchman.
Holding for the right for secrets.
Secrets. Also, shout outs to this super weird ad to be on the Mario Wiki. For a performance of God Looked Away with Al Pacino.
I love Al Pacino.
Dude, me too. I just watched The Godfather again for the first time. That movie is 45 years old.
Oh my god, I feel old.
Yeah, but also, like, Fuck, that movie does not look 45 years old.
Yeah, it doesn't.
Except for Marlon Brando's weird-ass face. Which, I don't know if you guys saw, but I did the Dex episode on Honch Crow, like, about a year ago or so.
Did we get... Oh, no, I didn't... Maybe I missed him.
What?
I think Anguarda is down here.
Yeah, he is, I think. Yeah, there's two different areas where Anguarda is in this level. But yeah, like... What was I saying?
Al Pacino? I think it's right here, actually.
Yeah, oh, I knew it. When I did the Honch Crow episode of the Dex, I was like reading about Marlon Brando because I did like a Marlon Brando impression.
Yeah.
And apparently that like weird face thing is just cotton balls in his mouth.
Yeah.
And like in some scenes you can just see him like licking him out of his mouth a little bit. It's so weird, like such a like famous performance, and it's just like a guy like, I got a cotton ball in my mouth. It's like really gross. Oh, there's the coin.
You know what's insane is, I think that movie may be the most, like, parodied movie of all time.
The Godfather?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know what the thing is that's crazy? I feel like people, like, don't even know the movie.
They know the parody, but not the movie. Absolutely.
They know, like, you come to me.
Yeah.
On this, my daughter's wedding day.
Zootopia did it.
You don't even call
literally,
me Godfather.
Literally, Zootopia did it, like, exactly.
Yeah.
A bunch of 90s cartoons, like... thrived in it.
The thing that's crazy about that scene, you know, it's like the first, it's like introduction of Vito Corleone.
Yeah.
What is actually happening in that scene, and I don't know why they would do this in a Disney movie like that, because it just makes me think of the scene. If you know the reference, you know that the scene is about a dude like begging the Godfather to get revenge on the guys that like raped his daughter and like beat her and stuff.
Yeah.
Well, they didn't rape her actually. She kept her honor, as he says. She fought him off, but she got all, like, fucked up and stuff.
Yeah.
So he was like, I want to kill him. And he's like, she didn't kill you. Your daughter's alive. You can't kill him.
Check this out. Gonna get this decayed coin. Oh, shit, not yet.
He's like, you don't even call me Godfather. Oh! Oh, my God. Fish out of water. Come on, guard. Oh.
You can do it.
Nanners. Get that life.
Slap that bass. All right, Swanky's bonus bonanza. Don't tell me, Alex. You ready? Here we go. Swanky swag. What is my name? Your name is Swanky. What's up? What is the first name of the enemy you see in the game? I'm gonna say a furry rat.
Got him.
What is the name of the island area of this island? It's gonna be.
It's the Gangplank Galleon. Definitely not the Gangland Galleon.
What did I just tell you? Don't tell me the answers.
I was just talking for my own.
Next one.
This is his big joy. This is
what is wrong? Why is the run button? What is the name of the first level in the game? Pirate Panic. It's not Pirate Picnic or Pirate Punch Up.
Pirate Punch Up would be.
What is the name of the enemy boss who's kidnapped? I'm gonna say Captain K Rool, not Captain K Rap or Corporal K Reap.
Corporal K Reap it.
Chimp Challenge, here we go. To the first levels of the game, how many windows did the captain's cabin have?
Ooh.
Four.
Damn.
What is the name of the first rigging level? Main Brace Mayhem. In the first level of the game, which of these is not in the background of the app? Oh, this one's always the worst. A sword, a map, or a gun?
What's the question?
What is not in the background?
Eesh.
A sword, a map, or a gun?
I don't know the answer.
It's either a sword or a gun. I'm gonna say a gun. Yes. Perfect. See you next week, bitches. What's up? Top sail trouble. Here we go.
Yeah, let's get in there.
Here's one of my favorite. I'm just gonna do this for me. Ready for this? Ready, Alex?
Yeah. What the fuck?
Wait for it. You paying attention? See this?
Yeah.
You paying attention?
I'm with you 100%.
You sure?
Yeah.
You sure?
I'm paying full attention.
I beat it.
In Germany, that level is very serious. It's called Sail Trauma. Sail Trauma. Sail!
Damn it, I was gonna do that. Wait, okay. Ted. Fuck it, let's get copyright. Ted, get the music from get that what? Song, the sail, but yeah. Like time it up from a cutscene from like Donkey Kong Country Returns, and get a shot of like Diddy like making a really like surprised face. Right when it's like sail.
Sail! Are you playing the level again?
I'm doing my completion thing.
Oh, you have to get the things.
I don't know if I did them all.
And yeah, again, let me reiterate. Please don't panic because Jirard is completing Donkey Kong Country 2 before your eyes.
No,
he literally
panic.
Does this.
Panic!
He literally
does
this.
You don't need to panic! You need to care about me so I feel important!
He literally just did. He does this shit every time he plays this game.
What?
Completes it?
Yeah.
Oh. Crow's Nest?
Almost. Making our way down that crow nest. Ooh, recover.
Making
what's up?
Making my way downtown. Walk in the darkness.
Walking the dog?
Walking the dog. Waiting for him to take a shit.
A-da-ba-ba-ba-boo, take a shit.
Wallace, why won't you shit on time? Wallace, why won't you shit on time? Why do you wanna do this to me? I'm gonna go to work.
That happens all the time. Alex is like, I can't come to work today. And I go, why? He goes, my dog's just taking a shit and, like, won't hang out.
I'm trying to, like, the thing is, Kelly doesn't believe me, but he, like, deliberately roasts me when she's not around. He just go on a walk and he just, like, won't poop.
He's just like,
he's like, yeah, we'll walk forever, bitch. I'll fucking, you'll walk me all over the goddamn town, stupid.
Yeah.
So it's true. I'm just sort of like, fine, we're gonna walk in a circle, bro, until you poop. That's how
checking
it's going to be.
Checking me out.
After I've already walked him around the block three times. I tell you, I treat that dog with too much respect. I don't get no respect.
Get no respect
from the
dog.
I don't get no respect from the dog.
What's the matter with you, huh?
Hey, I don't get no respect from the dog.
Hey, Pat, where the fuck did you come from?
Pat, what the fuck are you doing in here, man?
Pat.
It's great to see you, buddy.
I thought you went home.
Pat, holy shit.
Oh, you went shopping with Ted?
Yo, did you get a ruby red squirt?
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Hashtag... I want one.
Dude, Snapple, get the fuck out.
Oh, guys, 2017 needs a new Snapple.
It's the year of Ruby Red Squirt, bitch.
That's not true. No, because fuck... I don't want to say fuck Snapple. We love Snapple.
Yeah, you're right.
But seriously, Snapple, why the fuck are you like not getting back to us?
I'm just getting a little tired of being so much better of a brand ambassador for Snapple than anything else.
Than Snapple themselves. Did I get the DK Snapple, barrel? I did.
Snapple, seriously, 50K a year? No, you know what? 80K a year. Fuck it. It's worth it.
What?
Yeah. 80K a year. That's my final offer. I will run your Twitter for you and I will turn it into a meme
factory. I just want to point out that there... No one understands how we have changed the YouTube populace to fucking drink Diet Peach Snapple.
Everybody.
And you know what? Diet Peach Snapple sent us two certificates.
That's two gift certificates. A six pack each.
And yet they sent Ray, we love you, Ray, a fucking like carrier... Like Loot Crate version.
You leave Ray out of this.
No.
You leave Ray out of this.
Ray is my friend. I love Tina and Ray. I love their dog Charlie. Connor.
One time Ray bought me Steak and Shake. I would die for that man.
We love you, Ray.
He was also my first ever Twitch donation.
Oh really?
Yeah.
How much did he donate?
$69.
That's gonna be a full circle for you, Game Wiz fans, soon enough.
Okay, so this is Crow. This is the Crow's Nest. He's like a big version of Necky, basically.
Everyone knows Necky.
He wears a pirate hat. In Japanese, he's called Zaki, based on Necky. In Japanese, this level's called Battle Starts! Boss Zaki! Yep. Also, I don't know if you knew this, Crow's Nest is a pun, because this thing on an actual ship is also called a Crow's Nest, even though that's clearly a fucking vulture.
Also, Crow's Nest is from Final Fantasy XV.
What do you mean?
There is a, the diner, the crow's Nest.
Oh, that's right.
The chain.
Also, you guys might not know this, but crow's feet are something that's on my face.
What?
as you get older, you get wrinkles around your eyes called crow's feet.
Gotcha. Gangplank Galleon is 100% completed. You know why, Alex? You know how we know?
Because of the exclamation point in the DK coin?
Correct.
Did you know that it was originally supposed to take place during the storm, right after Topsail Trouble? But they put it in a windy setting like Main Base Mayhem instead at the end, because they probably just because it looks better.
How's our time, Pat? Are we good?
Junior?
Cool.
20? Dude, we're gonna wreck this.
I know. We're moving fast.
Yeah, so this is Crocodile Cauldron. This is the name of this land. Let's see. What's a good one? In Japanese, it's called Magma Cavern, quote-unquote, Crocodome. That's pretty funny. Yeah.
You guys are on World 2 on the first episode?
Yeah, dude. I know,
right? Fucking right. Dude, this is my game! It's my
jam! Come on, get real, dude. This is the game, dude.
This is the end of the completionist. What's up? Welcome.
Also, Hothead Hop.
It's over.
It's the name of this level.
I quit.
In Spanish, it's called Impulsive Jump.
And they're not really...
Oh! Beer Bros homework, film a vine. Oh.
Twitter video.
Film a Twitter video, TM, of yourself going, oh. That was the worst one I've ever done. I coughed on it. Film a Twitter video of yourself going, oh. Blah. Yeah. B-dub-a-dub-a-dub-a-W-B, sir.
Only on the WB.
Only on the WB.
Alex, time to talk about my favorite thing when I talk about this game.
Squitter?
The spider with fucking
tennis shoes. Hey, he's a spider with shoes.
First off, like, let's be real. Put a high-res image of the spider on screen dead.
A squitter?
Yeah. Not of a spider. Of the of squitter. Because I fucking hate spiders.
Yeah.
To death of me. But I will say, this is a fucking cute ass thing. Look at this.
Yeah.
He's happy as shit. Look at the way he walks. It's not creepy. It's cheerful.
It's true.
He's just like
as
making...
far as spiders go, he's pretty cute.
Yeah, he's tight.
Let me just say some things about Squitter.
Sure.
A little trivia for you guys.
Trivia about Squitter.
I don't know what this is implying. Squitter is one of the few spiders in the Donkey Kong franchise games to actually have 8 legs.
What?
Because I guess apparently most of them have 6. Dunno.
Alex, level design.
But the fucking smug-ass dude who wrote it on the wiki said, despite this, Squitter still lacks some spider features, such as multiple eyes and chelicerae.
What's chelicerae?
You know, I'm not even gonna look it up.
Great.
That's how you do trivia. Also, it seems like he buys his shoes at the same place that Espresso does. Espresso. Because he's a
the
fast
fucking
ostrich.
Ostrich?
Yeah, they have really similar shoes, except his are orange.
Alright.
It's the spider fang things. Okay, that's what Chilisari
are. Gotcha, so he's not a killing spider.
He just doesn't look as gross because he's missing the gross stuff that spiders have on their face. He just has, like, teeth and a mouth and eyes.
Guys, this is made by Rare.
Speaking of Rare.
I love Rare.
Speaking of Rare.
Grant Kirkhope, I love you.
Speaking of Grant Kirkhope, Squitter's name is referred to on Grunty's Tower of Tragedy quiz in Banjo-Tooie as one of the possible wrong answers to the question, what is blocking the vents in Grunty Industries' sewer system?
Oh!
One of the answers is Squitter.
You all need to go download the DKC2,
No, fuck that. You all need to go download Big Bad Boss's Power Overwhelming. Check that out on iTunes.
Yo,
Grant
Kirkhope. Karaoke track is... The karaoke CD is, like, coming out real soon.
Yeah.
We just went to production with it, so it'll be coming soon to you guys.
Grant Kirkhope
is on there.
He's fucking tight, dude.
I personally just want Grant Kirkhope on all of our albums.
In my mind,
Grant just becomes more of a legend in every album.
Can I just put something out there?
Yeah.
Let's just fucking try to do a full Let's Play of Ukulele with Grant. Let's just try.
I don't think he has that time.
Dude, if we just did, like 4 hours one day and cut each hour into half.
I don't.
That's 8 hours. We do one a week. We have plenty of time to meet up with him again, take him out and get wasted so that it's worth it for him to come down.
I love Grant Kirkhope. I love his family. I love that.
I love his family?
Yeah. Yeah. Max is a good kid.
Max, what's up, man?
What's up, Max?
Tell your dad we said hi to you on this episode.
Max, you probably don't watch Beer Bros, and you maybe check out Completionist every now and then.
Pro Jirard does, Max, so maybe you should start watching.
If you like Pro Jirard, yo, we got Pro Jirard, Max.
If you care what Pro Jirard likes, he likes this.
Yo. Yo, I know you don't like us, but Pro Jirard does, so that's okay.
Pro Jirard likes us, so you better start watching us just in case he makes a reference to us that you don't understand.
Cranky Challenge. What is the name of the first level? Hothead Hop. What is the name of this area of the island? Crocodile Cauldron. How many times do you have to nail the bird? I believe the answer is...
I don't know.
Four or six?
Dude, it's a fucking four. Great question.
Boom. Lucky Lava! What are the colors with the crocodile's heads you jumped on in the first part of the lava level?
I think it's green and brown.
Green. Green and brown is correct. Okay. Oh shit, I didn't read it. Was it red light? Red balloons? Yeah. Red balloons. Excluding the end of the area boss, how many levels were there on the first area of the island? There was the regular one. There was the first level. There was the...
Pretty sure there's five.
Did you look it up?
No, I didn't look it up, but I'm pretty sure there's five. All
right, you're right. I'll give that to you. All right. Gorilla game. How many banana bunches would you take to collect 100? Oh, no. Banana bunches. There's 10 in a bunch.
Okay.
So you need 10.
So 10.
Where did the beetle first area appear during the first area of the island? Level 2. What is the name of Diddy's ponytail girlfriend? Dixie.
Debbie. Debbie Kong.
Debbie Kong. Bureau's homework. Who is Debbie Kong?
Draw pick. Or, you know what? Make a Five Nights at Freddy's style animatronic of Debbie Kong.
Don't do that! All right. This coming up right here. This right here is the most bullshit of bonuses.
Is this Cannon's claim?
I think so. Are you ready for the most bullshit bonuses?
I fucking hate
bonuses?
Losing at this level, dude.
Look at this shit. Okay, check it out. Oh, man, what's over here? The fucking DK coin. One of the few bonuses in the game where the DK coin is hidden inside of the fucking bonus.
Troll.
It's bullshit. Because you don't think to look in there.
In Japanese, this is called barrel mine. I don't know why in French it's called Cannon's Complaint.
Just version variances, I guess.
I guess so.
Check this shit out. See this? Strats. That's called level design, my dude.
Speedrun strats. It's like not even a speedrun strat. Dude, Dixie is OP.
This game is like, it was designed for speedrunners. That's why I love it so much.
The third one is also like very...
I never played it.
What?
I never played it.
What do you mean you never played it?
Can I tell you like a quick story?
Is it, I never played Donkey Kong Country 3?
No. I mean...
Once upon a time, I never played Donkey Kong Country 3?
No, let me tell you a story. So my buddy Daryl Chang...
Okay.
We were in grade school.
Yeah.
He had...
He sounds like a television character, by the way.
Daryl Chang?
Yeah.
He's a good dude.
Great.
Oh boy, did I just fuck this up? I might have. Actually, you know what? No, I didn't fuck it up. Watch this. I am OP... Oh wait, maybe not.
Just go off the Kremlings.
What?
Just go off the alligator. You can't stop us.
Can't stop, won't stop.
I love this part of the song. Sounds like the Lion King. It's tight.
So Daryl Chang, he was that kid that like had a dad who lived in Japan, and so games always came out early.
I see.
And he had an early copy of the DK3? Japanese version of C3, and I just never got around. I watched him play it, and it like kind of like looking at it, I like became super fearful of like it being bad.
It has a different color palette than the other two games.
Yeah, it does.
I would say. But I will say this:
risks for the bisques.
It's crazy that you were like, "Oh man, love Donkey Kong Country. Donkey Kong Country 2, wow. Maybe my favorite game ever made. Third one, I'll skip it.
I think it's because I reached greatness, and my fear was like, you know what?
Done. Do you have it?
Ted, put a gif of Kevin Costner from Batman or from Man of Steel.
Okay.
Of him putting his hand out. That was me.
Okay.
That's it. That's me.
Now, just put a gif of that like weird baby monkey from DKC3.
Yeah, that does sound fun.
What is it? He's like a diaper wearing big giant baby monkey who's like stupid.
It's just a baby Kong.
But he's huge.
Yeah, he's just a baby.
And Diddy and Donkey aren't in the game.
Well, they are in some capacity, right?
I mean, I guess, but you don't play as them.
All right, this is the barrel I always forget about, but I'm gonna remember it now because I saw it.
Do 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 do.
Yeah. This is the trick.
What? Rocked.
Yeah.
Get boinked, sir.
Get boinkled.
Get boinkled, Pops. You old piece of crap.
Whoa.
Hell yeah. I'm not sorry. Oh.
Death.
I love that it's like fucking vultures and bandanas inside of a mine. Like, what the fuck is that? Hell yeah. Get wrecked.
Alright, we're gonna take a break.
Sick.
Next time on Beer Bros, we're gonna go ahead and do
Lava's.
The first Clubhouse Kiosk.
Clubhouse Kiosk.
Now, Clubhouse Kiosk, I'll explain all about it next time on the Beard Bros.
On Super Fart Brothers.
Where I'm not farting. That's
okay,
you.
Fine. Super Kong Bros.
That's okay.
Super. What's the thing? It's like hard dong, extend dong. What is it?
Expand dong.
Super expand dong bros. Can that be the name of this series?
You realize that everyone's just gonna tweet us that photo of like Donkey Kong like turning around like.
What? How about just like what do we call it? Super Conquest Bros.
Super Conquest Bros.
Super Kong's Quest.
All right, guys.
Super Beard Boys.
Bye. Goodbye.